Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to this TED Talk. Today, I'll be talking about the interaction between snow leopards and humans in Ladakh. Ladakh is one of the most beautiful places in the world, and we are fortunate to live in such a beautiful place. Ladakh has a diversity of wildlife, plants, animals, and it is so rich in biodiversity because it is located at the boundary between the Palearctic biogeographical realm and the Oriental biogeographical realm, and we get elements from both these biogeographical realms. It is also a transition zone between the vast open plains on the Tibetan Plateau and the rugged mountains of Western Ladakh, Hindu Kush, and Himalayan region, and that is why we get a diversity of wildlife adapted to these different habitats. Thirdly, Ladakh has a huge altitudinal gradient ranging from some 2,800 square kilometers to above 7,000 meters. Now going into the geological history a little bit. All of us know that the Indian plate collided with the Eurasian plate about 50 million years ago, and that gave rise to the Himalayas and the Tibetan Plateau. And that geographical upheaval, that geographical disturbance, created a lot of niches for wild animals, species coming from Africa, exploring new environments, new territories. This, the ancestors of woolly mammoth, for example, they were coming out of Africa looking for areas to adapt to, looking for exploring new territories. And then they made use of this huge, a number of niches created because of the rise of the Himalayas. Today, unfortunately, we don't have these animals amongst us. We just have heard its name. But fortunately, we have some other interesting animals like the snow leopard. I wonder how many of you have seen the snow leopard in the wild. Oh, that's quite a number of people. It's quite exciting, isn't it? I remember my first encounter of a wild snow leopard way back in the year 2000 in the Hamis National Park, where I was making a vegetation map of the Rumbak Valley. I was scanning the area for different types of vegetation when suddenly I saw two silhouettes of animals on a ridge line. I was accompanied by two friends, a Norwegian friend and a Nepali friend. And later those animals turned out to be the snow leopards. Barely able to contain our excitement, we went up that slope, reached the place where the snow leopards were sitting. But unfortunately, they were gone, and we were pretty disappointed. But not losing hope, we kept on looking around, and there were a lot of stony structures around that place, and I just hid behind those stony structures. And when I came out of the last stony structure, there they were, sitting some 15 meters from me, sitting there squarely looking at me, nonchalant. I didn't know what to do. I was pretty startled. I was trembling a bit. The first time I was seeing a wild snow leopard, and that also two of them together. It was a beautiful moment for me, and as well as for my friends. One of the snow leopards walked to the valley to the right, and one of them walked to the left. We kept on watching the one which went to the left for almost 15 minutes, and then it suddenly disappeared. There were no bushes, no rocks, no boulders. It just disappeared like that. And I think that is the height of camouflage. This animal is really known for that. And not surprisingly, it's called the ghost of the mountains. When I saw those two snow leopards for the first time, I realized that they were not mythical creatures. They were really snow leopards, living animals. They were not in the league of the North American Sasquatch and the Himalayan Yeti. The snow leopard existed. I was really excited and I was hooked. After that, I got an opportunity in the year 2002 to go on an expedition to the Shun Gorge of Zanskar Valley, one of the most beautiful places in Ladakh. We were pretty excited, and we were accompanied by some seven Zanskari porters. They were hardy, they were strong, they were helpful. And while walking in the frozen river, we saw them, some of them, walking barefoot to keep their shoes dry. Thin slices of ice lacerating their feet, turning the slushy water into crimson red. That was quite dramatic. And we just admired these people, these hardy people. We stopped in Padum, the headquarters of Zanskar, for 2 days to rest and restock our supplies. And we pushed off to the Shun Gorge, our final destination. On the way, we stopped in several villages. The people were really happy, very welcoming. They talked to us, told us many stories. They told us stories about how the snow leopard is lifting their sheep and goats from the pastures. But they didn't. It didn't seem, seem to matter much to them, single liftings. But they were angry at incidences when the snow leopard would get into a livestock pen and often kill 30 to 40 sheep and goats. And I could empathize with them. I myself is coming from a very small village called Skirbuchan, where I studied till the 10th standard. I used to go to school on the weekdays, and on the weekends, I used to tend sheep and goats in the mountains. And I could identify myself with them. I could understand their situation. Although like they didn't seem to bother much by individual pickings. They were pretty happy. They had minimal in their houses, very few varieties of things to eat, but they were happy, satisfied, and very helpful. We reached our final destination, the Shun Gorge, where we met our host, Sangdup. He had similar stories to tell. Now, 12 years fast forward, last year, we visited the same villages, and I was shocked to learn and see things. There was a sea of change. People didn't have time to talk to us. They were less welcoming. They were not very happy. They didn't seem very happy. They had a lot of materials in their houses. But that seemed unhappy. And reflecting on that, you know, what happened? I started thinking about, you know, other societies and other communities, and I visited other places. And then I realized, today's people have kind of become the more modern hunter-gatherers. They amass a lot of wealth, a lot of gadgets, a lot of appliances, oftentimes cheap Chinese-made gadgets and appliances. They go with them back to their villages, play if it is a radio, and they use like other materials for 15 days a month, and they again come back to the city to get it fixed. So today, people are very busy either acquiring new gadgets, new appliances, or fixing the old ones, which are not made of good material. And that apart, there are a lot of other issues, like the bureaucratic systems are so complicated today that common men, not only in Ladakh, but in other parts of the country and in the world, they, you know, spend a lot of time dealing with those issues. And obviously, they won't get much time to go to the nature, appreciate nature, and, you know, appreciate streams, rivers. They don't go outside. You know, they have very little appreciation for the nature. No wonder. But having said that, there are villages in Ladakh where people are really poor. They live under very poor conditions. They have very, they have to struggle on a day-to-day basis, eking out at their life from very marginal lands, which are not productive. In those cases, the Snow Leopard Conservancy India Trust stepped in. Tourism is becoming a big thing in Ladakh. Ladakh is fast becoming a hot tourist destination. There is a Ladakhi saying which goes like, the mountain passes are so high and the climatic conditions are so harsh that only the best of friends or the worst of enemies would like to visit us. But today that's not the case. People are flying over the passes and the climatic conditions are not that harsh as it used to be some 100 years ago when it was really cold and a lot of snow. And today, we are getting a lot of tourists and we should harness this potential. We should take the maximum out of it. And that's what we did. Snow Leopard Conservancy India Trust pioneered the Himalayan homestays in Ladakh with three objectives. First, to reduce pressures on the pasture lands. Second, to distribute the income from the tourism equitably. And third, to give tourists the opportunity to learn local culture firsthand. We also intervened in other ways. This is a place, a livestock pen, in one of the very remote villages in Zanskar. When we visited there, few women came to us and told us about all their problems. That the snow leopard is getting into these livestock pens and take sometimes a lot of sheep and goats, and so we wanted to do something there, and so we provided mesh wire. They had this livestock pens which were open from the top, and no surprise the snow leopard gets in and kills a lot of sheep and goats. Last year, we visited that village again to see the effectiveness of our intervention. And it was quite heartening to see some of these women. They were literally crying with happiness, with their eyes welled up with tears. And they told us this was a great help. Earlier, we used to sleep outside the livestock pens, quite often awake in the night, fearing that the snow leopard would come anytime and take our sheep and goats. But we are really relieved. We feel safe now. Now we can sleep inside our rooms, really happy. Thank you very much. And during those times, you really get the sense of an accomplishment. We really felt that, whatever we are doing are helping local communities live sustainably, live happily. And then the other things we do is, the handicraft development programs. All of us know that the younger generation in Ladakh, they don't wear the traditional gown, woolen gown called gos. And suddenly, the pastoralists of Ladakh lost at the wool market. But we are encouraging people to make other things which have a market. For example, a lot of tourists come, sometimes even during winter, and they go on treks, long treks, and they really need warm woolen hats, mittens, socks. So why don't we look for that market and produce things for that market? And people are really doing that, and they're appreciating that. More recently, we have been training them in something called a needle felting, where you take a chunk of wool and you keep on jabbing that with a special needle, and that it becomes three-dimensional and hard, and they make toy animals out of it. And a couple of years ago, one family made almost 80,000 rupees just by selling those toy animals. So you really have a lot of other options to live in this harsh environment happily and sustainably. Last but not the least, we are educating people, especially schools, kids. I visited a few schools a couple of years ago, and there I saw these young kids referring to large mammalian herbivores like the blue sheep and Asiatic ibex as deer. In fact, we don't have any deer in Ladakh. So we really have to, change that, and we really have to teach them. And the other thing is that, if we teach them now about all the environmental issues today, then they would be able to take very, swift decisions when they are at positions where they're in a position to, make policies and all. So it's really important that they're educated at this stage. And finally, I appeal to the people of Ladakh to use the resources judiciously, use the resources in a way that is economically viable, ecologically sustainable, and socially responsible, so that species like the snow leopard doesn't go the woolly rhinoceros' way. Thank you very much.